everyone! I'm here with my BFF Coco, and she's 12 years old now. All three of my cats are senior cats now. I have Eloise, who's 9, Haroon, who is 11, and Coco, who is 12. One thing that's really important for cats of all ages, but especially cats who are getting a little bit older, is for them to drink enough water. So I thought I would do a video with some tips and tricks for getting your cat to drink more water. Haroon! Do you need to drink more water? There are several reasons that cats might need to drink more water. One is that cats as a species tend to have a low thirst drive because their ancestors are desert animals who got most of their moisture from prey. So our house cats may not be drinking enough water on their own. Another is that as cats age, they can be prone to diseases that can be dehydrating or that require them to increase their fluid intake. And then there's the fact that cats are just so picky and they're very sensitive about the taste of water, as well as the type of bowl. So here are three easy ways to get your cat to drink more water. The first and most important is to get your cat a water fountain. This is by far the best way to get a cat to drink more water because many cats are not interested in drinking stagnant water. Water that's been sitting out is far less appealing to cats because it doesn't look fresh. So water in a fountain is much more natural feeling for them, and it appeals to more of their senses. They can see that it's running, they can hear it running, and it's just way more enticing than still water sitting in a bowl. You might notice that sometimes your cat likes to drink from the toilet or the tap, and that's because the water seems like a much more fresh source to them. But obviously, I think we'd all rather not have our cats drinking out of the toilet bowl, so a water fountain is a good alternative. Water fountains will have a replaceable filter that will give you a clean quality water. The one that I use has a 5-layer filtration system and a foam filter, so it removes any of that cat hair that lands in the water. It removes debris and mold. This one is the Pet Libro Hero Collection automatic fountain, and I love using it with my cats. It's a really smart design. It looks great in my house. And a lot of other water fountains I've found to be really clunky and hard to clean. This one is really simple. It has a rounded corner reservoir that you can just pop out and clean very easily, which also helps prevent mold. It has a very low noise pump, so it's not loud or disruptive in any way. One thing I recommend looking for when you're picking out a water fountain is to get something that's a bit wide and shallow. A lot of fountains have these very deep dishes, but cats do not like it when their whiskers touch the side, so they'll be a lot happier with something more like this that is shallow and wide. And that brings me to point 2, which is to make it easier for your cat to find and drink water. Cats can be very picky about where they drink their water, so try putting water sources in several places. You don't want to put it near their litter box or somewhere that they consider to be a little dirty. You want to put it in the places that they like to spend time. So in addition to your water fountain, you can add some low, wide water dishes or even get additional water fountains and put them in various places where your cat likes to hang out. You can put them on top of a table, you can put them in your kitchen, you could put it near their favorite bed. I even keep a water fountain in our patio because that's where the cats love to hang out. When you increase the likelihood that your cat is going to pass by a water source, you also increase the likelihood that they'll stop and take a drink. The third thing I recommend doing is increasing the water content of your cat's food. If your cat is eating kibble, try to switch them to wet food. Like I said earlier, cats as a species have historically gotten quite a lot of their water intake from just eating their food. But when a cat eats dry food, it doesn't give them any hydration. So try to find a moisture-rich wet food that your cat really likes. And keep in mind that there are a lot of different textures of wet foods, from shreds to pâtés to more gravy-rich foods. So try a bunch of options until you find one that your cat loves. That's gonna make a big difference for them. But whatever your cat prefers to eat, you can increase their water intake by simply adding some extra liquid straight into their food. For kibble, you can rehydrate it by soaking in a bit of water before you feed them. For wet food, you can add just enough water to the food that it mixes in thoroughly, and they can get more fluid intake that way. And you don't just have to add water. You can get creative with things like tuna juice or ice cubes, or even adding a little bit of meaty baby food, which which can be really enticing for the cat. There are also some great moisture-rich cat treats that you can try as a supplement to your cat's diet. Ultimately, it's all about what works best for your cat. So give each of these things a try and see what works for you. I know that since switching to water fountains and adding more fluid into my cat's diet, I've seen a huge difference, and I hope you do too. And hey, while you're at it, don't forget to drink some water yourself. It's good for you. Thanks for watching!